Hello, my name is Suwan Choi, Artistic Director of the Korean Performing Arts Institute of Chicago, or KPAC for short. KPAC was founded in 2013 by Executive Director Byung-seok Kim. Located in Wheeling, Illinois, KPAC promotes Korean traditional music, including folk drumming, which is called pungo. We had been working with various Asian percussion teams and thought it was important to get to know teams from other cultures as well to increase cross-cultural understanding, especially in an area as diverse as Chicago. That is how we came to host the very first Chicago Drum Festival in 2019. But we were not able to do so last year due to the pandemic. Even though we are not able to hold the festival in person this year, we are so excited to present diverse drumming traditions virtually. Community is the key component of the Korean drumming tradition called pungmo. Pungmo was very much rooted in village life. Its function was and is to bring people together. Music has the power to transcend boundaries, whether person to person, nation to nation, or culture to culture. So I hope this drum festival can help us build a larger drumming community in Chicago in a similar way. This year, we invited four folk drumming teams: Thai, Brazilian, Japanese, and African. Including KPAC, representing Korean drumming, you will see five great performances. Please enjoy.
The band exists since 1988, when I moved to Chicago, and pretty much there was no Brazilian music here. We mostly play samba music, different styles of samba. There are at least 20 fusions with samba, with African drums, and we do most of them, we play most of them. And the drums is so important because the drums came from Africa and they are like diffused with different styles. Start with the Portuguese, a little element from the Indians, but even today, like we have like the jazz, like American culture, like influencing our music, you know, hip hop, jazz, and some other styles from other parts of the world as well. Yeah, the group, like, is what you see over here is five people, but the group, usually when we play the full band, is nine people. And we have like six dancers and costumes. It's a big group. And we do a lot of parades, we do a lot of festivals, we do a lot of private events as well, universities, now you name it. So we've been doing that for 33 years, and we love to do it. And we always bring this joy, like the percussion make people dance. Like, people always dance with those percussion called Batucada. That's the name of the percussion. So we named this Batucada Chicago. That's what we call it, because that's the way we play it. But the roots are in Brazil. And before Brazil, it was in Africa. The whole world has percussion. Now we have to unite through percussion. I think one thing that's very important is even some culture like here in the US that we don't have a culture of percussion. We're introducing that like from different parts of the world, African, the Jamaicans, the Latinos, and the Brazilians, of course. Brazilians play a very important role in this complex.
Sawadee krap. My name is Chamni Sripraram. I am the music director, the Thai music director of the at the Northern Illinois University School of Music. Today, our ensemble, the Thai classical music, want to present the Kloing Yao ensemble that you will hear after this. We would like to talk about the function of this ensemble, particularly for the Kloing Yao, is to celebrate any kind of event in the village. In Thailand, in Laos, in Myanmar, and Cambodian. I bring this in the component of the drum. This is the drum skin on top. It's made by the calf skin. And this is the body of the drum. And you can look closely, it's really long. So the definition of the ensemble Kloing Yao, particularly we can translate into the English by Kloing mean drum, Yao is mean long. So it's practically is the long drum ensemble. And it's symbolic of the Southeast Asian mainland. We can say that the bronze culture, bronze and bamboo culture, this is the transfer to throughout of the Southeast Asia culture of this type of music. Thank you.
Tsukasa Taiko is by far one of the largest community-based Taiko group or Taiko program in the Midwest. We have over 50 members. And the kind of music that we play at the Tsukasa Taiko is a little bit different from what's commonly known as a North American Kumidaiko ensemble taiko music. I think I try to bring in what I used to play when I was a teenager in Tokyo and kind of bringing that aesthetics to Chicago. So I think stylistically it's a little different from what's known as a taiko drumming in America, you know. So I think we Tsukasa Taiko have a very distinctive style for that. So I think the most important thing about our participation to the festival is because it was an invitation from KPAC, and it really means a lot to be with my friendship with Byeonsang, my friendship with Suwan and everybody else there. So that's a very important kind of it's a festival, but it's also very, very interpersonal in a community-oriented relationship that we value a lot, right? And also, I think it's one of its kind. I don't think we ever had drumming festival in Chicago. So it's something that we always look forward to be part of. And also, a multicultural aspect of it. Different kind of Asian drumming, different kind of ethnic drumming are kind of put together into one day festival. I think it's really, really great.
We are Ayodele Drum and Dance. We are an all-women's drum organization that practices and utilizes traditional West African music and culture to fuse with everyday life of the woman's living. So we utilize the drums to instill confidence, pride, and stability for our communities and family. Djembes, dundumbas, we have some other percussive instruments like the krin. These are all traditional drum instruments from West Africa, predominantly the old Mali Empire. So you will find these drums played in Mali, Guinea, West Africa, and Senegal, and Ivory Coast and other countries utilize these instruments also. There was also a time where Westernized society told us as women that we could not play the djembe drums and we shouldn't play these drums, that they were for men to play. So just giving a little bit of resistance, right? Being able to allow this instrument to instill that sense of power for us as women, we use it as a tool of communication, bringing people together, and being able to also teach our children what the tradition is of the African people. On my journeys to Africa, I learned that not just men play these instruments, but the women play these instruments as well. So starting an organization where we could utilize this music to show strength and show confidence and show pride was very, very important for me to instill with the women dancers that I was working with in the community of Chicago. Thank you.
Thank you.